Quick history. Bilingually equipping you with knowledge of the past. What actually is GDP and how do you calculate it? GDP is possibly the most talked about financial term, and the chances are very high that you've come across this abbreviation sometime this week or even on our channel when we refer to the economic history of countries. Though most people don't seem to know what GDP actually means. This short video will explain, in simple terms, GDP's definition, how to calculate it, and why it's very important to you. Also with historic analyzation as an added bonus. Let's tackle the first part of the question, the meaning. GDP is just a quick way of saying gross domestic product, which is defined as a measure of the size and health of a country's economy over a period of time. Now that's all good, though how do you measure the size and health of an economy? There are actually three ways to do this. First, you could sum up what everyone in the country has spent, and yes, that does include everything starting from the food on your table. Alternatively, you could sum up everyone's earnings in the country of a specific time period, or you could finally use the most common method, which is to sum up the total value of all the country's goods, such as the electronic device you're using to watch this video, and services, such as the platform YouTube, which you're using right now. Now that you've understood what GDP means and how it's calculated, how important is the term to you in your daily life? Surely it doesn't impact you if some figure rises and falls. In fact, you should actually consider GDP as a very important factor to make many financial decisions, as knowing the figure allows you to easily understand your country's economy and make better decisions such as when to invest or grow your company through marketing. For example, when the GDP rises, it generally means the economy is growing as more people are paying for goods and services, in turn expanding businesses. So, starting a hairdressing company when the GDP is rising will have a higher chance of succeeding as more people will be willing to open their wallet for a trim. However, this scenario will most likely be the opposite when the GDP is falling. Another reason why GDP is useful is because you can work out where your country's economy stands in comparison to other countries by working out what percentage of GDP your nation holds against the whole world. Do this by dividing your country's GDP by the whole world's GDP. Great! So now you know what the term GDP means. Let's use this learning to dip into a bit of economical history and briefly analyze some changes. As it's visible on the graph, in the year 1600 AD, Asia had, by far, the largest GDP percentage as a proportion of the whole world. To be exact, 65.5%. This was mainly due to the plenty of raw materials found in the continent, which were traded with other nations. If you would like to know more about trading of raw materials, click the icon on the top right of the screen. In turn, we can see that the Western world didn't have such a strong holding. Though fast forward to 2003, and Asia's share had drastically been reduced, and the Western world had leveled out, mainly due to technological advancements in the US and Europe, though also because many nations were still recovering from colonization decades previous. As this video comes to an end, look out for the next English video, as we'll be looking at the advantages and disadvantages of GDP and its effects upon history, alongside more recent and relatable data. And as a bonus, we'll explain the definition of GDP per capita as well. If you enjoyed this video, subscribe, sound the notification bell, share, and give this video a thumbs up. Quick history.